Please welcome on stage a gentleman who encapsulates the very essence of what is variety, Mr. Timmy Nairn.
Scottish midlife crisis. I'm finding Susan Boyle sexy. No, I don't understand the world anymore. In this modern day, kids run wild, but dogs go to obedience school. How do we figure that one out? And also, when I was a kid, you had to go to the circus to see the fat lady with tattoos. Now, they're on the Jeremy Kyle show every day. Different world. Okay, but the kids miss out to me and the things that we used to have. We used to go to the Saturday morning matinees, and it was always the cowboys. And you always knew when the bad guy was riding in, because the honky-tonk piano and the saloon stopped playing. And in the distance, you heard this twanging guitar. That guitar was played by a gentleman named Dwayne Eddy. Can you remember Dwayne Eddy? Great guitars. Well, in his band, he had a sax player with the amazing name of Boots Randolph. He did number one hit all over America with a honky-tonk hillbilly rocker titled Yakety Sax. They released it in Britain as a single, and it flopped. There was only one copy. Until about 16 years later, somebody decided to use it as a theme for a television programme, and it ended up getting into the British top 10. Now, I've told you it's called Yakety Sax. What I want you to do is get a thinking cap on. See if you can remember the television programme. Okay, Peter, here we go. put me out to my misery. What was the television programme? Now, Penny Hillshire, poor old Penny, thrown off the television for being what they call politically incorrect. What the nonsense. All it was good old-fashioned seaside postcard humour, and these idiots took it serious. Do you know, I just saw on television the other day there, 40 years ago, Coca-Cola did an advert, and they said it's still the best advert they ever did. I'll run it by you, and your lips will move. Here we go. I'd like to teach the world to sing in perfect harmony. Do you remember that? It was the Seekers, and there was three of them. And then they went away, and then they come back as the New Seekers, and there was five of them. And then they went away, and then they come back as the Asylum Seekers. Rest my game. You know something, I'm going to offend somebody, but I don't care. I am sick to the back teeth of Romanians coming into this country and taking jobs off Polish people. You know something, I have the privilege of working on a lot of cruise ships, and one of the questions I always tend to get asked is, who do you reckon was the finest clarinet player of all time? Well, to me it falls into two categories. The finest technical was a gentleman named Benny Goodman. I don't know if that name rings a bell with anybody at all. Fabulous player. But the fastest clarinet player was a gentleman named Artie Shaw, known as the Baltimore Bullet. Basically because of the speed they could play this instrument. Now in the hands of Artie Shaw, this was not a clarinet, it was a machine gun. So what I'll try and do for you is show you how you can play one instrument two entirely different ways. The laid back style that was Benny Goodman and the sheer speed and aggression of Artie Shaw. Hopefully you will notice the difference. Hopefully I will as well. Okay Peter, here we go. Junk in a pint. Well, maybe, maybe not, because I like to do something a little bit different. I like to transport you now all the way from the sunny North Pier Plateau. I'm kidding, did you walk it down tonight? All the way up to Edinburgh Castle, and the Edinburgh Military Tattoo. Has anyone ever been to the tattoo? Well, you know, don't watch it on television because you don't get the atmosphere. When you're up there and you're sitting in the battlements, you see the mass pipes and drums, and the lights go down at midnight to blackout. And you gaze up and you see the lone piper and defy not to have a tear in your eye. Because that's what the bagpipe does. It generates its own atmosphere. And you know, tonight, you've generated your own atmosphere. You've an absolute joy to entertain. Thank you so much for my little spot. And if you take anything from my performance at all, it's one thing, simply, grow old disgracefully. Simple, go out tomorrow, throw a bucket of white paint over a seagull and say, how do you like it?
Thank you. Here comes the surprise, Jimmy Nairn!